The launch of China's third aircraft carrier, the Fujian, marked a significant milestone in the country's naval modernization. As attention now turns to the possibility of a nuclear-powered carrier, both interest and skepticism are growing. Satellite imagery and land-based test facilities suggest preparations are underway. Yet, building a nuclear-powered vessel is far more complex than assembling a conventional one. It requires compact reactor design, seamless integration with a ship's systems, and the highest levels of nuclear safety. Experts note that China's experience with nuclear propulsion has so far been limited to submarines, which differ significantly in engineering and operational demands from surface ships. Even if technical hurdles can be overcome, strategic questions remain. China's current security priorities are regional, centered on the Taiwan Strait and South China Sea, areas well within range of conventionally powered carriers. Additionally, the rise of hypersonic weapons and unmanned aerial systems is altering naval warfare, reducing the survivability of large vessels in contested zones. Critics argue that investing heavily in a nuclear-powered carrier may not offer proportional strategic returns. In contrast, proponents believe nuclear carriers are essential for global power projection. Such vessels offer virtually unlimited endurance, freeing fleets from dependence on supply chains and overseas bases. While some foreign observers suggest that China should focus instead on asymmetric technologies or enhancing existing platforms, others see the push for nuclear carriers as a signal of long-term ambition. Ultimately, the decision to pursue nuclear-powered carriers will depend on a combination of technical readiness, budgetary priorities, and evolving defense doctrine. Whether seen as a symbol of prestige or a practical tool, nuclear propulsion represents a significant shift in naval capability. For China, the debate is not just about hardware, but about the kind of naval force it intends to become in the decades ahead.